Hey fans, so here we are in this cute little skeleton layout of the Shoreline Trolley Museum, or as you could call it, the Branford Electric Railway. Thanks to Brandon Phelan, who laid the track, we have... So far, we don't really have a lot of equipment in terms of, like, trolleys that we could use for this kind of a museum setup, but once we finish decorating and putting in the train, I'm sure we'll be able to find a few things to populate this line with. So this right here is Edgewood switch, supposed to be a spring switch, but I don't think Train Simulator has the I don't think Train Simulator has the capability for you to put in a spring switch. If it actually does and I'm not aware, just let me know in the comments or something. So, here we are at Short Beach, where we would typically turn the pole, but since there is no wire and the pantograph is up instead of the poles, we're just going to change cabs and head on back. Or not, I forgot this car is single-ended, so I guess I'll have to back up? I don't know. So normally a car like this wouldn't be allowed over the trestle and into Sprague, but because I need to move this out of the way for some other stuff, I'm just gonna bring this car to Sprague and leave it there for the time being. I don't remember if I mentioned it before, but like I said, right now there's currently no track gradient and no scenery. I am looking for people who are willing to do all that stuff. So if you are, I have a couple people in mind already. I will be contacting them as well, but if you are interested and you are capable, please let me know in the comments section. The ultimate goal is to have this on the workshop as a downloadable route. Alright, so we are at Edgewood. We have to throw Edgewood so we can right rail. Edgewood is thrown. Now let's take a look at... I forgot what this switch is called. Not good. Anyways, okay, that's Alex loop switch. Throw that. Alright, so we're gonna put this at Sprague and leave it there. Alright, so I'm gonna switch over from the Sacramento car to the TTC PCC car, which is currently sitting on 32 track. Gotta throw some switches. And we are ready to go down the line. Alright. I don't remember if everything works here or not. Let's see. Yeah, I think we'll put this car back on 32 track. Yeah, before someone mentions it, yes, I know I'm back polling, going like 40 miles an hour, but I am not sitting here for 30 minutes while I back pole the entire main line at 4 miles an hour. Just saying. Okay, now for the real test. Let's see if the arrows can handle this curve. In real life, there's no way the arrows would fit. There's like 85-foot cars, probably too heavy. Track is not the right quality for any of this type of equipment, but it's a simulator, so I'm gonna mess around with it exactly the way I want to. So we're gonna run the arrows down to Short Beach, come back, see if they'll navigate the loop switch without derailing through the loop, and call it a day. Oh, there's a piece of missing rail there. I'll have Brandon take a look at that. So this right here would be where the high-level platform would be, where we board the subway cars when they're out and running. We're coming up on Narragansett Switch, which I just threw for us. So these tracks over here are the new barn areas. The loop tracks, the runaround track hasn't been completed yet. I'll have to send Brandon the track plans for that. So he can have that runaround constructed. Otherwise, track-wise, the route is pretty much complete. Just gotta, once again, add in scenery and put in the track gradients and the signaling. And fix that switch thing over here. It should not be in the middle of the right-of-way. So you might have noticed me stopping here because right here in front of us should be the Farm River Road grade crossing. You're supposed to stop here, check for traffic, two dings and go. Alright, here comes the moment of truth. We are going to take a pair of 85-foot cars around this loop, which in real life would not work. But in the game, I'm sure it will look quite cheesy. So, here we go. I cannot believe this is actually working right now. Alright, now that I'm done messing around on the loop, we're gonna bring this through Sando and back through the high levels to whatever the hell track it was on before. You know what? I'm actually gonna see if I can put this up on 94 track. Or 91, I don't remember which way those barns are numbered. Let's see. Yeah, I guess we'll use that one. All right, and there you have it. It's the skeleton for the Shoreline Trolley Museum, also known as the Branford Electric Railway. Once again, if you are willing to and capable of decorating, slash adding signals, slash adding in the track gradient, let me know in the comment section, and I will see if I can cobble together a development team. Once again, many thanks to Brandon Phelan, developer of the Northeast Corridor between New Haven and Boston, for laying the track. I'll send over the report so that he can fix whatever that missing thing was and complete the runaround track around the new barns, and we should be good with that. Once again, thanks for watching, and stay tuned for much more. Till next time, see ya!